tous, welcome back to Lingoni. My name is Alicia and today I will teach you the verbs of the first group. In French we have three groups and the first group are the verbs ending in ER except for a couple of exceptions like aller, who is completely irregular. Let me remind you that aller in present simple that we've seen in past classes would go je vais, tu vas, il va, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont. He's not following any pattern, but normally verbs in ER are the verbs from the first group. They're also the easiest to remember, you'll see why, and they follow a very stable, let's say, like ending and structure. So I thought I would choose like 10 very common, useful and basic verbs in ER from the first group, and there I will recycle some sentences that we've seen in the past and make some short sentences with them. Not really sentences, but vocab that we've been seeing in the past, and probably formulate short sentences with them. All right? So the 10 verbs that I chose are parler, to talk, to speak, parler, ending in ER, regarder, to look, to watch, regarder, marcher, to walk, étudier, of course, to study, travailler, to work, aimer, to like, to enjoy, to love, s'appeler, to be called, it's like when you say my name is, je m'appelle, acheter, to buy, usually pronounced acheter, again we have the E in the middle that we eat up, manger, to eat, and jouer, to play. Couple of things that are very important. First, when you will be speaking in present simple, you must never forget to put the pronoun. It's not optional like in some languages. We always need to put je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. The pronunciation of il, elle in singular and in plural is exactly the same. So do not try to put an ils or an else to make me understand that it's plural. It's just the way it is. We pronounce it exactly the same way. You would pronounce the final S if the verb that follows starts with a vowel, like ils aiment, they like. But apart from that, you do not have to pronounce the final S in il or in elle. And then, verb-wise, I will take parler and I will conjugate this one. The structure will be the same for all the other verbs that we chose here. And I will tell you what you have to remember absolutely, because it's really important when you will be speaking in present simple with all the verb in ER. If you remember that, you already have like more than half of the job done as far as pronunciation is concerned, which is already a lot. So parler, you would say je parle, tu parles, il parle. As you can see, it's the same pronunciation. That's why you need the pronoun. Otherwise, it's very difficult to understand. Je parle, tu parles, il parle. The only distinction when you write is that with tu parles, you would need to add an S. Again, it's not optional. We do not pronounce it, but we write it. It's a mistake to not write it. Je parle, tu parles, final S. Il parle, ou elle parle, of course, if it's a girl. So je and il, elle are written the same, tu with final S, and the pronunciation is the same for all of them. Nous parlons, final O-N-S. Remember that as well, final O-N-S, always. I can hear like very weird things with the nous. Nous parlons, O-N-S, always, nasal sound. Vous parlez, E-Z, vous parlez, pronounced as if it was an E with a stress on top of it, un accent aigu. Vous parlez. Il parle. Tricky one. Very tricky one. Here, I can hear everything and anything coming out from my student's mouth. You're complicating it a lot. It's weird. But the plural, when it's a verb in ER, il ou elle, first, as I told you before, the pronoun is the same. It might be singular or plural, you will pronounce it the same. Il, elle, but you add the final S when you write. But the verb is also pronounced the same, even though it is extremely important to always remember to put an ENT, a final ENT at the end of your verb when it's plural. When it's il or elle with a final S, remember to always put, if you write it, if you say it as it's written, parlent. But you will never pronounce it. Never. It's just letters that are here to mark the plural. So the weird thing is that sometimes if you don't have a context, which is impossible, if you're having a conversation with someone, you should have a context. But il parle, if I just say il parle, and I tell you write it, it's perfectly correct to write it il parle, everything in singular, or il parle, everything in plural, because the pronunciation would be the same. Again, normally when you're talking, I know if you're talking about like il parle, one person or people, because I have the context, but the pronunciation would be the same. Okay, written, the ent in plural is not optional. Remember that. And do not get confused with ons and ent. Ons is with nous. Nous parlons, nasal sound. Vous parlez, il parle, parlent. I will give you the sentences I made, and you can just practice them, repeating them, or trying to translate, or just maybe changing the person. I write, for example, I said, je parle français. I said, je m'appelle Alicia et je parle français. You could like change these sentences, trying to put it with tu, for example. That's a good practice you could do on your own. Je m'appelle Alicia et je parle français. Tu regardes un film. You watch a movie or you're watching a movie. Il marche lentement. He walks slowly. Elle parle beaucoup. She speaks a lot. Elle parle beaucoup. Nous jouons aux échecs. We play chess. Vous travaillez avec Jenny. You work with Jenny. Vous... it could be someone I'm talking about in a formal way, with vous, or it could be several people. Ils aiment, I know, here I can hear the final S, but it's only because the verb aimer starts with a vowel. Ils aiment, written I meant, ils aiment le football. However, if I say ils jouent au football, they play football, you cannot hear the final S. Ils jouent au football. And one more, elles achètent, again, elles achètent, because it starts with A, les cadeaux de Noël. Elles achètent les cadeaux de Noël. They buy or they are buying the Christmas present. What do you need to remember? You always put your subject when you speak, like the pronoun, je, tu, il, nous, vous, il. You do not pronounce the final S in il, plural, even though it's tempting because you want to make the differentiation between singular and plural. There is none. And you remember that the ending of the verb in er are e, es, e, ons, ez. I should say all this in French, right? E, es, e. O-N-S, E-Z, E-N-T. And the pronunciation is the same for four forms of them. So the whole singular is pronounced the same, and the third person plural is pronounced the same as well. I will just do one more, like travailler, because I said parler at the beginning of the class. So I will conjugate now travailler. You could stop the video, try to do it first, and check if you did it properly. Je travaille, tu travailles, il travaille, nous travaillons, vous travaillez, il travaille. That's all for today, guys. Well done. That's a huge step forward with the ER verbs. We'll be now able to formulate sentences and see a lot of more vocabs, and it's great. Remember to also review your verb aller, which is ending in ER but is completely irregular. And soon we'll go back to être and avoir, to be and to have, like the full conjugation. Remember to go on lingoni.com to practice all that. You'll find like the 3,000 interactive exercises, 200 worksheets, 300 videos, and a lot of podcasts and everything you need to practice on your own after this lesson we've been doing together. And as always, do not hesitate to leave a comment or to ask a question if there is anything I can do to help. It's always a pleasure. Merci beaucoup. À bientôt. Salut.